City of Houston, Space City, Screwston, a city with a culture like no other.
The city of Houston is easily the most diverse city in the country.
I just think it's the people that make Houston great.
I'm an entrepreneur. I've started a couple of businesses in different industries.
I'm the owner and operator of Le Macro Food Truck.
I teach two periods of basic journalism, J1, and then two periods of yearbook and one period of newspaper.
I'm a radio personality for 93.7 The Beat, club DJ. Right now, I'm a partner with a great, incredible team of a squad called the Relief Gang.
When I first heard about Harvey, it was Thursday before it hit. I was thinking, oh, at worst, we'll just have a three-day weekend.
We packed, you know, food for about 2 weeks because we didn't know how the storms were going
to
be.
In Galveston, the waters were going to be high. So I went down there to take my boat and put it in my driveway in Galveston. When I pulled the boat out and had it on the trailer, for some reason I changed my mind. And I thought, you know what? I'm just gonna bring the boat back to Houston. You know, the rain started coming and it was coming in sheets.
So I just put a tweet out. It's like, hey, if you need help, let me know. And the response was overwhelming.
With that much inventory, we just decided to just go ahead and start giving it away and not charge anybody anything. And from there, it just kind of snowballed.
I saw this article. People were using this app to call for help when they were needing rescues. Probably around 10:30 or 11 is when I started listening. The calls just kept getting more and more frequent. People saying they were in their house with water to their waist and they couldn't get out and they needed help.
I was woken up early with a phone call, and it was the River Oaks police. And they had heard from a friend of mine that I had a boat. 15 minutes later, I'm in the water with these police officers boating down Kirby Drive.
As I was looking for places to go, Gallery of Furniture, it's on the news saying that they need help. We called Mr. Mattress Mac, and he said, don't even call me, just show up. So just come out here anytime you want, because we've got so many people. As we parked, that's when all the people saw us, so they all came out and they started lining up.
Okay. Went to Costco, filled up a cart, a couple in the line that was behind me. They're like, hey, are you doing this for a shelter or something? And I was like, no. I was like, we're actually just going out to people that reached out on social media. And then the next morning, that same guy was there, but he had like six other guys with him with trucks and canoes and kayaks.
I would listen to them on the app, and I would just scribble the information, and then I would go to my laptop and enter that information in the database. And I just kept taking calls all night.
And then my cell phone started to just go crazy with text messages. People had saw that I had a boat. And I didn't realize it at the time, but people were in trouble all over the city.
Trey was actually rescued on a boat from his home. He just stayed on a boat, lost his home, didn't worry about any of his belongings, and just started saving people himself and never got out the water, literally, till the water dried up.
If y'all have any addresses of people that's in high water that can't get out of their home, they've been blocked in their home and can't drive because the water too high, make sure y'all hit us and tag us with the address.
He saw what I had in my heart, I saw what he had in his. It was like, hey, let's just work together. And as we did it, people just started, you know, following the lead and showing up wherever we were at. And the Relief Gang just kind of formed that way.
As we were finishing the day, we were completely almost out of food. There was a little girl, and she had her head down. She hasn't eaten it. And it was with her mom, dad, and her grandfather. That's when I connected as a kid, you know, and saying, man, you know, there was a lot of times that we went hungry. So we had some beef patties. I threw them in the griddle, and then I started chopping them. And then one of the guys was saying, what are you doing? He goes, like, you know, it's a burger. We don't have any bread or anything. I said, just don't worry about it. We got plenty of tortillas. So then I started chopping it. Obviously, I was in tears.
I heard a young boy. He told me that two other boys in the house had gone outside and hadn't come back in. I just heard this awful, blood-curdling screaming. He said, Miss, my brother's dead. I think he's dead. I think they were electrocuted. And it was like nothing I've ever experienced. And I said, let me talk to your mom. And so she came to the phone, and I just said, I'm so sorry. And at that point, she was crying, and I was crying, and we just hung up. I mean, it's the most helpless feeling in the world.
Okay, we're coming in.
We came in through here to try to see what we could do to help, and this is where we identified upstairs here a woman who was out of oxygen, out of her meds. She was in need of medical attention. She was in really bad shape. One of the kind neighbors here had taken her upstairs because their first floor apartment had been flooded out.
Yeah, we brought him up, and we had to carry her because she was, she was not able to walk on her own. So we brought him up and let him stay for that night. And so eventually they came out and waved down a boat, and I guess you were on it.
Yes. Our boat.
As the husband and his wife were being boated off to safety, he turned back and saw us, and he gave us this great smile. Yeah. And I remember looking at you going, yeah, that was worth it. Yeah.
My understanding was I think they got her to the hospital, and
is she okay?
No, I'm sorry to say she's not. She passed at the hospital like a day later. So it was rough.
You know, the range of emotions. You know, I felt like a failure on that. I just felt like we could have done something differently.
So right now we're in the Relief Gang warehouse located right here in the heart of Houston, near the Astrodome. You can get any more Houston than that. The initial donations came from our pockets. When people saw that, they started paying forward.
I got the homie with me today.
Hey.
Ace Time, where we at right now?
Representing that tray.
Beyonce, they actually came out with us, took her to CUNY Home, which is Third Ward, which is her neighborhood.
You can see the donations are definitely abundant. Prepackaged boxes of everything, just, you know, all non-perishable.
Beyonce donated $75,000 worth of mattresses.
They found a way to where you can put a king size in your car. We also have these big bags where you got toilet paper, paper towels, and you got blankets. First class blankets, not the thin ones. We created these buckets with everything we felt that someone might need in their homes to clean up. Gloves, Lysol, the bleach. So this is like a medical bag.
So this is a high necessity section right there. That's the diapers.
Back here, we have a bunch of walkers.
It's all kinds of toys, games, a little bit of everything. We've already given out at least $700,000 worth of supplies.
Trey and I, we're headed to Home Depot to get the supplies and building materials. Basically, sheetrock, tape, and mud for three homes that we're gonna adopt. 16 sheets and a 4x8 half inch.
Everybody don't get approved by FEMA, so a lot of people kind of just be stuck. So we just try and offset the cost as much as we can.
And it's way beyond the call of duty. These people here are from upstairs.
All right, good luck.
All right, you all take care. When this many people come out, yeah, the best of Texas is showing. Okay? You can't beat it.
You know, the pride comes from being a part of the team of Houstonians who stepped up and did something.
I don't think anybody could have heard what I was hearing and not do something. I'm glad that I was in the right place at the right time and that I was able to help.
I need to do this, you know, the Houston, you know, needs it, you know, the city needs it, you know.
If there's a hero, the hero is my boat. The hero is my neighbors who showed up. The hero is the paramedic who did his job. If you could have seen what I saw, then you would be in love with your city and your state, because we've got it in us.